Now we're going to look at two main concepts in ROC analysis. The first one is the ISO performance lines. The idea here is very simple. If you draw a line through ROC space, then the points in the ROC curves that intersect with the straight line have the same performance. And this performance is measured by the slope of this line. The gray line that I drew intersected the ROC curves in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. All these points have the same performance, and thus they fall on ISO performance line. So you see, these lines can be determined by the objective of optimization, such as the lines that can give maximum accuracy or specificity or sensitivity. Another important concept is the concept of the area under the curve. An ROC curve with a larger area under it performs better on average than an ROC curve that has a smaller area. In our case here, you see the green line has a lesser area than the red line under it. Thus, the SVC performs better than the logistic regression. Since a greater AUC, or area under the curve, implies better performance, in our case, we choose the random forest classifier as it performs best on average given the area under the curve is the greatest. One very interesting property of the ROC curve is that it is invariant under the class distribution, and thus the results are applicable to a data set with different proportion of class instances. What this means is that it doesn't matter as far as the ROC analysis goes as to which class has how many points to train upon.